So today we will talk about the Dam Safety Bill 2021, and this is recently passed by the Rajya Sabha. So remember that. So in this video we will talk about why Dam Safety Bill in news, what is actually the dam, why Dam Safety Bill is needed, and what is the basic features of dam, and what is the main bone contention, or basically you can say the flaws related to bill. So let's talk about. If you talk about why news, as I told you that on December 2nd, the Rajya Sabha passes the Dam Safety Bill 2021 to set up the institutional mechanism, basically the framework try to establish, basically to reduce the disaster which is related to dams. So this is to ensure the safe functioning of dams in the country. If you talk about, then what is the dam? What is the main meaning of dam? Then remember that dams are an artificial barrier. So remember that it is not a natural barrier but an artificial barrier which is done through the human. So this is very very important, which establish or store the water, help in irrigation, power generation, flood moderation, and the maintain the water supply. This is what do you mean by the dam. So dams is basically an artificial barrier which is basically main job is to store water, and that water can be used anywhere if condition required. What is the condition required? So this is the basic meaning of dam. So remember that. If you talk about the highest dam, which is the Tehri Dam in Uttarakhand, basically 206.5 meter, remember that. And if you talk about, there is a distinction between the large dam and the small dam. So remember that those who are between the 10 to 15 meter, remember that basically comes under the small and medium dam. And if it exceeds the more than 15 meter, then it will consider the large dam. And the largest dam in India, if you talk about, that is the Tehri Dam in Uttarakhand, 206.5 meter. This is the basic information if you talk about. So now let's talk about actually the why the bill is needed. So remember that. So this is not the first step actually taken by the parliament to make a law on dam safety. So remember that in 2007 actually the Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal passed the resolution. Why they passed the resolution? Because water under the 17 of state lists, entry 17 of the state lists, water is a state subject, and you have to make, or parliament have to make a law, then states have to pass a resolution, and that resolution is passed by the Andhra Pradesh and the West Bengal. And that time actually parliament took a step to make a law on dam safety, but actually the bill lapses in 2010 because of the parliament left or dismissed, you can say. So this is very very important step, earlier it was taken. But now if you talk about, this bill is under the entry 56 of the list 1 under article 246 has been passed. If you talk about, now remember that what is entry 56. Remember that entry 17 of the state list is basically subject to the entry 56, and which fully empowers the parliament to make a law on the basis of inter and intrastate river, etc., or if that is management related to that, which comes under the article 246. That is under the article entry 56 related to the intra and water management of that water, comes under the entry 56 of union list. List 1 is union list, remember that, under the 7th schedule. And article 46 basically empowers the parliament to make a law. So this is very very important if you talk about. And that's why this bill comes under the article 256. As I have told you that earlier, the Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal passed the resolution to make a law on this subject, and in 2010 the bill was introduced but lapses under article. So remember that here the bill is introduced under article 252. What is article 252? If you talk about that, then if the two state or more state passes a resolution or refers to parliament to make a law, that comes under the article 252. This is very very important. And now the bill has been passed under article 246 if you talk about. And as you have seen that Mulla Periyar Dam frequently in news and a contention between the Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So now we will talk about actually why the dam is needed. So these are the basic facts which you need to provide it, and that's why I have provided you. So before we go why this bill is needed, we have to look at the some data. So let's talk about. So if you talk about the same facts related to the dams, then remember that the report by the United Nations University, Canadian-based Institutes for Water and Environment and Health. So this is the data has been provided that if you talk about, then India has total at around the 5,745 large dams. In this, if you talk about 1,000 plus large dams in India will be 50 years old by 2025 if you talk about. And if you talk about 4,250 plus large dams in India will be 50 years old by 25. And if you talk about 74 plus large dams in India will be 150 years old. If you talk about, according to this report, then 3.5 million around the 35 lakh people at risk if the Mulaperiyar dams were failed, which is a bond contention between the Kerala and Tamil Nadu. This is the importance of dams, and that's why this bill is needed. The main issue is that the loss of life and aging dams is the why it is important, because it poses the high risk and it leads to loss of life basically, and higher maintenance cost, and as well as if there is any failure, then can lead to the immediate crisis in the particular state or even in the country, lead to the water irrigation. And if you talk about the sedimentation, as you know very well, and flood can occur, even this is the kind of problem which through these aging dams can predict. For that, you need the proper maintenance of dams, and that's why through this bill we can provide the proper maintenance. So this is very, very important. If you talk about the, in June 2000, as I told you, this is the total large dam, and 25% of dams will be 20 years old, and 2020 large dams more than 100 years old if you talk about. And if you talk about specifically the Mulaperiyar dam, then remember that this has been built around the 1875, so this is specifically the 100 years old. So you need to remember this point. So this is very, very important. If you talk about largest dam state, then Maharashtra is the largest dam state, around the 2,319 foot. After that the Madhya Pradesh, and then the Gujarat. And if you talk about main issue, as I told you, the loss of life is the main issue, and obviously it poses risk. It can occur flood, there is a sedimentation risk, or there can't be a immediate crisis of water shortage, irrigation, etc. can take place, and that's why the proper maintenance of the dam is very, very important, and that's why this bill is important. So now let's talk about the main features of the bill. So I've told you that why this bill is needed. Now the features of the bill, as I've told you, that bill will provide the surveillance, inspection, operation and maintenance of all specified dams. Remember that this is a keyword, all specified dams across the country, means irrespective of the state, irrespective of the union territory. This is the bill basically for all the specified dams. Remember that. If you talk about, it provides actually the two national bodies. Remember that there is already a national body, remember that, Central Dam Safety Organization under the Central Water Commission. So this is very, very important. Now there is under the two national body, if you talk about National Committees on Dam Safety. What is the main job or function of the National Committee on Dam Safety? Formulate policies related to dam safety and recommendation regarding the dam safety is the main functions of National Committee on Dam Safety. Another is the National Dam Safety Authority. What is the main job of this authority? Is implementing policies formulated by National Committee on Dam Safety. And if you talk about providing technical assistance to the state dam safety organization. If you talk about under this bill, there are the two state bodies as well. So we will talk about, but what is the main job? National Dam Safety Authority to implement the policies formulated by National Committee on Dam Safety and provide the technical assistance and resolving matter between the state dam safety organization of a state and between a state dam safety state organization and any owner. If you talk about, this is the main functions of the National Dam Safety Authority. If you talk about under this bill, there are the two state bodies. The first is the State Committee on Dam Safety and another is the Dam Safety Organization. These are the two committees. So remember that we'll be responsible for surveillance, inspection, monitoring the operation and maintenance of dams within their jurisdiction. Like the Mulaperiyar dam actually belongs to the Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Then within their jurisdiction in Kerala and Tamil Nadu, these two states actually provide the inspection, surveillance and technical assistance, whatever is required. And obviously this national committee and the state committee will be a coordinated committee and will work as a coordinated body. So remember that. Further in this bill, that functions of the national and the state bodies provided under the dam safety bill can be amended by a notification. So this is one of the contention and one of the issues that if there is any functions related to national and state body can be amended by a central government by only a notification rather than passing a separate bill or separate function related to this central body. So remember that if you talk about. Another is offense under the bill can lead to imprisonment of up to 2 years and a fine or both. So remember that this is one of the offense. Remember that dams are managed by the central government, state government or a private agency as well. Remember that this is not only done by the central government or state government but also by the private organization or anything like that. Remember that. Now, what is the issues involved in the dam safety bill? Remember that firstly regarding the federal structure. Some states are saying this is against the federal structure because center has no power. As I have told you that entry 57 is clearly saying that related to the inter and intra state river, center has the power actually to make a law or parliament has the power to make a law. And remember that in Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal actually passed a resolution on that. So remember that actually that supports the argument of passing this bill. So remember that. Now what is the another issue? As I have told you that the state bodies and central bodies functions actually can be amended by a notification. This is one of the issue. Some state also the raising the question that they are taking the state power. But this is not actually same. So this is very very important. So if you talk about the summary of this video, so this is a very positive bill which will provide the safety related to dam and it will decrease the risk. Remember that. And obviously it also not declines the role of state. There is a two body and which will coordinate with the national body and then lead to a conclusion. So this is very very important. If you talk about the what things you need to remember that, remember that it is across the all specified dams in the country, two national bodies and two state bodies. So remember that. Thank you guys. Hope you will like this video.